Okay, welcome to Research 601, Module 4. In this module, we're going to finally test our hypothesis. We've worked up to this readiness to do this in every module. In Module 1, we prepared our data set by removing invalid cases and replacing missing data. In Module 2, we conducted our factor analysis and our reliability testing and computed our variables. In Module 4, we ran out our descriptives and ran a correlation table, and now finally we're ready to test our hypothesis. In this data set, we only have one hypothesis, and that is that engagement attitude is positively related to engagement behavior. And so it's really actually a pretty easy process. We're just going to go analyze. We'll come down to regression, linear regression. Our dependent variable is engagement behavior. Our independent variable is engagement attitude. Let's look at our statistics. That's really all we need is the default. We don't really need any plots. Everything else is fine. So let's just go ahead and run our analysis. Okay. Now, what does this tell us? We actually get four things here. First, we get our variables entered and removed. It just lists that engagement attitude is our variable, and we're looking at its relationship to our dependent variable, which is engagement behavior. The next three tables, they're the ones we're actually using. We want to look at the last one, well, the significance in the last two. In the ANOVA, the significance just tells us that our model is significant, okay? But the one we're really concerned about is in the coefficients. And that's just that engineering attitude and its relationship with engagement behavior is significant at the point less than 0.001 level. If you click this, it tells you, it'll give you the actual amount, which is 6.3747 to the 19th, negative 19th power, which is a pretty small number. We just say it's less than 0.001. So that's a significant relationship. So right there, that tells us our hypothesis is supported. We can reject the null hypothesis that there is no relationship and accept the hypothesis that engineering engagement attitude is positively related to engagement behavior. So the next question, okay, so it's significant. How significant is it? Okay, we come back to the model summary here and look at R squared. The R squared is 0.269. Now what that tells us is that 26% or 27% actually of the variance in engagement behavior is related to the variance in our independent variable, which is engagement attitude. So stating it the other way around, engagement attitude explains 27% of the variance in engagement behavior. To put that in a slope, we look at our beta here in our coefficients. We can see our coefficient here is 0.519. It's a positive value, it's not a negative value, so that tells us our relationship is positive as we hypothesized. 0.519, that means for every one unit increase and engagement attitude, we have an increase 0.52 in engagement behavior. So that's a pretty substantial amount there. And that's what we're really interested in. What you'll want to put in your paper are these three tables, the model summary, the ANOVA, the coefficients. Some people put all three tables in the model. Some people create a summary table that only puts those things they're interested in. Either one's fine. I usually go with all three, but that's really the only things you're really concerned about. You're concerned about the significance of the relationship. You're concerned about the percent of the variance that's explained with the relationship and how much of a change is that? What's the beta there? What is the slope of that line? And that's really it for linear regression. So play around with this a little bit. Play with some of the other variables. We'll go into a little more depth next module when we look at mediation and moderation.